Oh my, I didn't know you needed a ticket to get in here. Oh well. Hopefully nobody hasn't said a word. I really don't know. We're back at SeaWorld Orlando because in just starting this Saturday, I believe it's Saturday because that's the 16th. It's too hot. Starts their SeaWorld Halloween Spectacular. Then of course going into that night would be Howl-O-Scream. I'm not going to Howl-O-Scream until probably sometime in October. But we're here back at SeaWorld Orlando. Have a little fun. Enjoy ourselves. Kind of your entrance into Halloween this year. And also guys, I can show you guys the parking lot. It's a Wednesday, so it's not really that busy today at SeaWorld. It should be a fun day. No waves today. Very sad to see this. Let's make our way inside the park now. Samantha goes by. Really just no general wait to even get inside the park neither. I think our first stop is going to be the SeaWorld store. Oh my god, right when we walk in, Halloween stuff's for sale over here. Oh, they're actually putting out too as well. We'll have to come back another day just to check out, see what they have fully. A Halloween candy grid Christmas tree, I like that. Not really a fan of candy corn. Still not working. I like candy corn blanket. What should you go for? $36, that's not bad. I was expecting $35. Very cool to see all this stuff out. Good yourself. And of course your Halloween stuff right there. Your Halloween lanyard, your Halloween pins. This house is no longer our house. Probably my favorite house right here, but again, we're not here to talk about Halloween. We're here to talk about SeaWorld's Spectacular as well. Up here we go as well. More Halloween merchandise for sale. Just right outside the store. Stickers to decorate your buckets for when you guys do go trick-or-treating. I think it's kind of a better price than different Mickey's Not So Scary in general. I'm just saying, because you can go trick-or-treating and you get a bucket that more than a plastic bag. You can decorate it too. This is, I think, 100% more better for the kids as well. They even got purple buckets, and the if you guys go to Halloween, no boo necklace, but you don't get scared. I think it's like $15. Fans. I actually like that shirt for kids. That's really cool. Race you to the candy. But now that we are here in SeaWorld, we're not going to go to Waterfront right away. We're going to be taking the back way in near Key West, near the Dolphin Enclosure. But just be alert, I think, by either Friday or even Friday night, they'll throw the fall stuff up onto this for the photo ops. It is really not that busy. There goes Manta. Manta's sitting at a 25-minute wait too as well, but normally, because I think they only operate like with one train vehicle, so might be a little longer than that, so it might even be like 15 minutes, but yeah, I highly recommend it. If you wanna, if you're a big fan of coasters, come out during the week, probably get a lot done. We're by the Build-A-Bear Workshop, entering Team 2 Key West. Well, only one face is showing. Look at that. Branches is kind of covering up SeaWorld Spectacular as well. Oh, face painting too, look at that. Keep on walking too as well. We got a power ship being attacked by a spider with lightning bolts on it. Normally a pirate does meet during this event. And oh wow, got some seahorses right here, both sides. Oh, that's jellyfish. This is where the mermaid meets. There's something new right here too as well. Coconut Bay Traders. They also have Halloween merchandise. Very cool to see the wind chimes. What chimes I really don't see a price for? I guess it'd have to be like $20. I could always ask when I go inside. Very cool stuff. Very cool. Which are candy. This is from last year too as well. Alright, cool, I kinda like this. For $30. I like this. So for the wind chimes, I don't go check right now because there wasn't a price, but here's more Halloween merch. And so snacks, water, sodas. If you need it. Some buckets from the Key West. And of course if your bucket does get full, you always get one of these reusable ones for about, oh, it looks like they cut the price off. That's the best part, you're never gonna know. As you can see, I have your first, where you come get candy. You can just see it just hanging out right here. No sign to what it's gonna be yet, but you guys will know that on Saturday. Candy corn umbrella, I like that. Oh, the big guy's deflated on top of the Stingray Lagoon. That's kind of gives you an idea where it's at. And you guys will see boobs just going all along this trail right here. Here is another booth. Let's go to the candy corn umbrella. And again, of course, they're not going to show you what they're selling because the event hasn't begun yet. That's what it looks like. Nobody is checking out the Miami Dolphins. What a shame. And like I have said before, they're gonna see just boobs like this just all along this area back path right here. There's another entrance too as well. We'll show you that in a little bit. There's the other booth right there as well. Just some photo ops right here that you guys have. Then it's the Great Pumpkin Charlie Brown with pumpkin fish in there. Plenty of photo ops. I think there's a story time in there as well. I know they had it last year. Another candy trail right here and over by where the, well, yeah, where you can view the Miami Dolphins practicing for football, even playing football, even on Sundays. It's just right there. But yeah, let's go check out the Miami Dolphins. Let's go see if they are practicing right now. Oh, there's Tua right there. Oh, there's Tyreek and Jalen. Wow. They're just having a good time practicing. After being the Chargers on Sunday, so they're enjoying themselves. And then you have to go up to Foxborough to play the Patriots this Sunday as well. Very cool to see this. Yeah, I ain't gonna lie to most people, I'm a Patriots fan. And I'm not really a fan of the Miami Dolphins, nor Tyreek Hill. Wow, looks like we have a food booth this year right here. Very cool to see this. I believe this was a photo op last year, but now it's a food booth. Now we have some treats with some white pumpkins. All along here, and I'm actually shocked the pumpkins are still fine, even in this Florida heat. They're not carved, that's probably why. That's either a speaker or a fog machine. They get a little spooky. Not scary, but a little spooky. Just all along here, you have the trees. another other fog boost speaker. I'm gonna guess that's a speaker, so that way they've covered it up. And then you have a photo up right here too as well, and there will be characters meeting right here as well. Scarecrows are now out. This is normally where the party does begin at. It all depends on which way you guys want to take for house. For not house, Goomba. Spectacular. And then of course a nice little photo op right here for the kids. Tell you guys the truth, the leaves changing colors up there. Yeah, they're still green down here. But it's the magic part. Well, so let's walk around, try to look for some good thumbnails too as well. Here's where the DJ's booth is. And there are just a lot of just trail treats, even over by Journey Atlantis, even where the aquarium entrance is as well, right over there. So I'm giving you guys all the help you guys can get. So this isn't really too good right now, especially with stanchions in front of all of Kraken. This thing is here, I'm gonna wait, yeah, here it is. It is closed for maintenance, sorry for the inconvenience. So just be aware of that, not all the rides are gonna be open when you guys wanna come. If you guys give me a second, let me get my Pokemon Go on real quick. Lapidoof. Maybe that horsey, no, it's gotta be the Eevee, has my name on it. Pikachu. But I think the Eevee has my name on it. Also, as we're just making our way out of here, more photo ops. But not only that, looks like the wall got pushed out a little farther now than what it normally was. Rumored roller coaster for 2024. Oh, they're not turned on, they're deflated. Oh no. Oh well. So to turn around and show you guys where it says the Hollow Scream signs, but this is Manta entrance. Then if you walk right, just right up here, it says right entrance is right here, but it says ambassadors only. So this kind of doesn't make sense. So you guys go, just show you where some houses and scares those are at and how to get to the park exit as well. You keep on walking. Can't go up this way because that's where the scare zone's at. And here's your house. One of the houses right here. My personal favorite. Can't wait to do this year. So no real tight look at the construction update for the rumored roller coaster 25. This. But yeah, nothing's really gone vertical yet. They're still working on it. Even just right up there too as well. Really nothing too new. Don't worry guys, we got your roadkill hot dogs here, fresh right off the market. Roadkill hot dogs, fresh right off the streets. So this is new as well. Oh, a little mermaid diver, sweet, good to know. Also, I haven't seen the Sky Tiger up in a while. Hope it's fine. Anybody want a Hollow Scream baseball jersey or that hoodie? I actually like that hoodie. How much does this hoodie go for? I'd buy that. It's a nice hoodie. It has a houses on the back of it. I would buy that. I like that hoodie a lot. So for the last couple weeks, it has been cool outside. No humidity, no nothing. It is really hot today. Really hot. But Mako, only 10 minutes, not bad. I can't wait to see this show. It's really good. Now, I'm not sure if they do anything at Sesame Street for Zero's Halloween Spectacular, but it wouldn't be bad to take a quick look. I don't really see nothing set up in here, though. I really don't. Yeah, I don't see anything set up if they were going to do something over here. Really nothing. Maybe they got merchandise for sale for Halloween. We can go take a look real quick. Nope, I was wrong. I'm just gonna really have to spray some new stuff out. My body is asking for water, even though I just had a cup of water. Oh my, it is hot out here. It's a meltdown. Siren's crying, or siren song. Find me some water. So it's about 92, 93 degrees outside. I'm not going inside the SeaWorld Hollow Scream store, no. I'm going inside Wild Arctic. Oh, you can hear it feels good. And it's dark too. I like it like this. As we are leaving Wild Arctic, this is now covered off. I don't really see nothing to change around in there, but yeah. I got my free water too as well before I get to this place. Icebreaker, only a 5 minute wait, maybe even a walk on. We're almost out of here though. We're almost there. Looks like some refurbishment is happening over where the Kilauea enclosure is. Well, not enclosure, where the Shamu Stadium is. Looks like they're doing a little bit of refurbishment over there. I'm not gonna lie to nobody, it does look like they're even also setting up to put their Christmas trees out very soon. There's like one person on that train right there. Another thing that I've noticed the last couple times I've been here, the Sky Tower hasn't really gone up that as often as it used to. And I'm only going to be guessing just due to the fact that it's $5 a person to ride. And who knows how many times pass holders are going to come out during a week. So who knows until this thing actually does start going again, but for the time being it's been just sitting right there. Or maybe they just don't have enough people for it to even want to go up. Who knows. Their next spot will just be over by Pipeline. Check out that wait time and then make our way out of here. And for Cirrus News Coaster Pipeline, only 5 minutes, not too bad. I remember that guy setting me up. Well, that's how far you can walk up to. You can't go any farther than that. All right, SeaWorld. I'm getting out of here. And I'll see you guys in the next one, which should be Halloween Horror Nights.